Students, our next topic is delegation of authority, a process of entrusting responsibility and authority to the subordinates and creating accountability on those employees who are entrusted responsibility and authority. See, delegation of authority, you can feel in your class also. Sometimes your subject teacher or sometimes your class teacher may give you some work related with the class. So that will also be treated as a delegation of authority. But in that case, accountability will be of class teacher and subject teacher. So to help out your senior will be treated as delegation of authority. So it's a process of entrusting responsibility and authority to the subordinates and creating accountability on those employees who are entrusted responsibility and authority. So in every organization, managers are assigned lot of work and manager alone cannot perform all the work. So he divides the work among different individuals working under him according to their qualification and get the work done from them. The manager begins with sharing of his responsibility with his subordinates, and he deliberately passes some of his responsibility to his subordinates. So after passing the responsibility, the manager also shares some of his authority, that is power to take decision with his subordinate, so that the responsibilities can be carried on properly. To make sure that his subordinates perform all the work effectively and efficiently, it is expected that in the expected manner, the manager creates accountability, and this whole process is known as delegation. So delegation can be defined as a process of entrusting responsibility and authority to the subordinates and creating accountability on those employees who are entrusted responsibility and authority. So in simple words, delegation refers to downward transfer of authority from superior to subordinate. But in this case, always remember one thing, accountability will be of senior only. So delegation of authority is having basically three elements, that is responsibility, authority, and accountability. So first of all, we will discuss about responsibility. Responsibility means the work assigned to an individual, and it includes all the physical and mental activities to be performed by the employees at a particular job position. The process of delegation begins when manager passes on some of his responsibilities to his subordinate, which means responsibility can be delegated. Means you can pass some of your responsibility to your subordinate. And there are various features of responsibility. Responsibility is the obligation of a subordinate to properly perform the assigned duty, and it arises from superior-subordinate relationship because subordinate is bound to perform the duty assigned by his superior. Responsibility flows upward because subordinate will always be responsible to his superior. In this chain, our second element is authority. Authority means power to take decision. To carry on the responsibilities, every employee needs to have some authority. So when managers are passing their responsibilities to the subordinates, they also pass some of the authority to the subordinate. The delegating authority is the second step of organizing process. While sharing the authority, managers keep in mind that the authority matching to the responsibility should only be delegated. They shall not pass all the authority to their subordinate. Now there are few features of authority. In a formal organization, authority arises or originates from an individual's position. Authority refers to right to take decision due to your managerial position, and authority is restricted by law and rules and regulation of the organization. Now in next element of delegation is accountability. To make sure that the employees or subordinates perform their responsibility in their expected manner, the accountability is created. Accountability means answerability. Okay. Accountability means subordinate will be answerable for the non-completion of the task. Creating accountability is the third and final step of delegation process. The accountability cannot be passed or delegated. It can only be shared with the subordinate, which means even after delegating responsibility and authority, the managers will be accountable for non-completion of tasks. If subordinate of managers are not able to complete any task in that particular condition, only manager will be responsible for that particular situation. There are a few features of accountability. Accountability refers to answerable for the final output, and it cannot be delegated or passed. It enforced through regular feedback on the extent of work accomplished, and it flows upward. That is, subordinate will be accountable to his superior.